the head of the French energy giant Total says rebalancing the oil market will take time. The CEO, Patrick Pouyanné, spoke exclusively just hours ago here at the Future Investment Summit in the Saudi capital and talked about the future of the partnership between OPEC and the other oil-producing countries. Take a listen.
In these markets, we had two, 3 years of oversupply. Inventories went high, so you don't manage to rebalance, which means really to have some drawdown of inventories in 3-4 months. The markets are too reactive. And I think that when I look to what happened between Saudi Arabia and Russia, both countries are committed to rebalance the market. And I think they need to send a strong signal to the market that this deal will last for long. And I noticed that the words of Vladimir Putin last week were going in that direction, and the historic visit of the King Salman to Russia is also, I think, a signal to the market. So my view is that this agreement, first, is efficient, quite compliant, and should be maintained.
So that raises the other question as to how quickly the market is going to rebalance and also what that means for prices going into 2018.
You know, prices are volatile. Look, today you are at 56. People ask every day, when do we go at 60? But 2 months ago, we were at 44, for 30% of difference in 2 months. That's true that there is rebalancing, but you know, we know that the season, there is a seasonal demand. That demand in this during summertime, third quarter is high, so you have some drawdown of inventories. We also know by during winter, first quarter of next year, demand will be low, and so inventories will go up. Then the markets are overreactive, so it's why it's difficult. So rebalancing will take time, and so it's why we need to have a constant policy by OPEC and non-OPEC countries.
Yeah. So in terms of a range where prices might average 2018?
No idea. You know, I will tell you, internally I've asked my teams to prepare at 50, 40 and 60. So you know, my range is quite big, you know, and we'll see. But again, by the way, you know, the main objective we have is to lower our break-even. And next year, our break-even pre-M&A will be under $30 per barrel. So my company is strong and we can face whatever the price will be.
Let's bring it back to the company. ENGIE's LNG assets, they're saying that they're talking to quite a few people. How keen are you on buying that?
Total is a big player in LNG, among the top three. We always said in our strategy that we are willing to grow in LNG. The gas markets are one of the markets which will grow in the future. And LNG is one of the technology where we are very, a demand to develop. So we look to various opportunities, and I can confirm we discuss with ENGIE like other companies, and we'll see if we can find an agreement. If not, we have other ideas, you know, other opportunities to develop the LNG business.
So you'd say you're quite keen to pick this one up?
No, it is not what I told you, that we are in discussion, and we'll see if we can conclude or not. But we are in discussion on many LNG projects in the world, and ENGIE portfolio is one of the opportunities that we are looking at.